On a slightly more serious note, I think part of what we need to do to go forward is to look back. So I've been playing around with this metaphor of the cyanobacteria and what we can learn from them. We can also learn from our human past. Maybe in order to go forward, we need to remember indigenous knowledge. Gathered dusk sounds of the moon, their echoes humming in the amniotic fluid, blood flowing through the placenta, now bringing with it BPA, phthalates, PCBs to break up the heartbeat of the body it had begun to reside in. Silences and sounds building to a soft crescendo, marking the time of approaching birth, each step moving forward. Deaf to sounds outside its sphere, now trampled upon by aliens such as endocrine disruptors, carcinogens, mutagens, neurotoxins, DDT, organophosphates. Those lost silences were absolute. drumbeat of its dependency. Silences and sounds our inheritance before birth to curl up and sleep, restful like animals. Unable to find them again, those silent postures, as we leave the womb, our spine stiffens, interfered with. We are different than we were meant to be. Silences that formed and molded us are festooned with chemicals in the womb. Postures we once shared knew them in our bones. Those silences no longer seem asleep. They're developmental disorders, cellular distortions, childhood lead poisonings, Minamata diseases, diabetes, autisms, ADHDs, obesities. This could be our legacy instead. Return to the cusp of the womb. Expunge these strangers in our midst. Buried past untold sorrows of the earth. Regain once more our innocence. Touch each heartbeat of those first silences where fellow creatures live and sleep.